All right, welcome once again to my channel. This is the Healing Center NG. This is the Healing Center NG, where we share the gospel about the miraculous power of God that is, you know, bringing healing to the world where needed. It brings healing to the people who want a hunger for the healing power of God to rest on their body. Because there are people who, because of the afflictions they are going through, they don't know where to face. What's the solution? How can I get out of this situation? You are in the right place. The Word of God is the solution to whatsoever challenges that you may be facing right now. So today, we are going to be looking at 10 days of healing, day 3, by George and Terry Pearson. Day 3 says, yes, but will he? That is day 3. You know, a lot of people used to ask questions, you know, does God want me to be healed? So if God wants me to be healed, why am I going through all these things in my body? All right, let's look at Matthew chapter 8, verse 1 to 3. Matthew chapter 8, verse 1 to 3. It says, I will be thou clean. Jesus was talking to a leper that came to Jesus and said, if you will, you can make me clean. And Jesus responded by saying that I will be clean. You see, the leper knew he could, but would he? That's the question. I will was not a passive response, but sure, okay, I'll do that. You know, God said that, not impulsive, not acquiescent. He said, I will reveal his character and his nature. I am glad too, that is Jesus. I would rather do this than anything else. God wants you to be healed. So if there's anything God wants to do for you, is to ensure that you don't live the same you came in his presence. And we can see him do that over and again in the gospel. So he says, I will reveal his character and his nature. I am glad to. I would rather do this than anything else. It is by gracious design, not determined resolve. It is as if Jesus were saying, healing is who I am. Matthew chapter 8, verse 5 to 13. Jesus' word is his will. So if you want to know the will of God, you see it in the Word of God. If you want to see the will of God, where do you see it? You see the will of God in the Word of God. What the centurion understood, and he confessed, A, Jesus' word was his will. B, his word would do whatever he would do. Whatever he would do, talking about Jesus, he most certainly would, because he would only say what he willed or intended. This is believing. God can do what he will. God will his will. Praise God. God will his will. God spoke only what he wills. His spirit is bound by the same design to empower his word. What he will, he says. What he says, walk to his will. Praise God. You know, I'm enjoying this. You see, that statement is a spiritual law. It's a spiritual law. You know, the way we are sharing this thing, we are breaking it down for you to understand that for you to actually be healed of affliction or disease or sickness, you need to come to that point in your life where you believe nothing other than the Word of God. You take the Word of God, you cash in your healing. I don't know whether you get what I said. I say, when you take the Word of God to the bank, you cash your healing. Praise God. Because God's intention is for everyone to be healed. It's for everyone to be healthy. But why are my people sick? Is there no balm in Gilead? That is the word of the Lord. See, it says, I will. Scriptures. Exodus chapter 15 verse 26. I will not put the diseases on you, for I am the Lord who heals you. God is the one who heals us. A. He reveals what he is made of. B. This reveals how he is designed. It reveals how Jesus, how God is what? Is designed. He's designed to heal you. He's designed to make you free from sickness, from pain. God wants you to be healed. So you are not supposed to carry sickness in your body and be moving around. As a believing Christian, you are supposed to let go. Why? Because the Bible said, by his stripes you are healed. Do you have understanding of that word? He said, himself bore our sicknesses and our infirmities. So why are you still carrying the pain? Why are you still carrying the sickness, the burden, the affliction? I take authority in the name of Jesus. I speak over your health, that whatsoever it is that is trying to put you down, the power of God touches your body right now and removes that affliction in the name of Jesus. I speak to you that is afflicted by the evil one. If he sent us an arrow and is returning back to wherever he was sent from, right now, by the power in the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost, move on your behalf and remove that pain, that sickness out of your body forever in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember, it is only him that can set you free. I can only pray for you, but who does the work? Remember, this is a spiritual law. The word of God carries power. Just like the spiritual word is what controls the material world. When you speak, things happen. Why? Because the spiritual world is controlled by words. Somebody will ask me, am I a spirit? Why do I know what will happen? Yes, you are a spirit. You have a soul and you are living in a body. And this is it. This body is a cloth. So how do you know that things will happen when you speak it? Why? Because the word of God says so. He said, when you decree a thing, it will come to pass. He said, whatever you permit in heaven is permitted on earth. That is John chapter 18. Verse 19, it says, whatsoever you bound on earth, 18:18, is bound in heaven. Whatsoever you lose on earth is loose in heaven. So I'm speaking to you to start losing, start binding every sickness and pain around your body and say, get out of my body, because this is not where you're supposed to reside. And when you speak it, the power of God is what carries that word into the spiritual world and make it a reality in your body, which is a material world. Praise God. So right now we are talking about, you know, the 10 days of healing, looking at day 3. It says, this reveals how he is designed. Exodus 23 verse 25 says, I will take sickness away. For instance, this pill will make that sickness go away. It was designed to do that. Praise God. The pill, that's talking about the medicine you take. In the same way that the pill won't put the disease on you, God won't put sickness on your body. Now we are not discrediting the medicine. The medicine works. The power of God works too. But what would you prefer, to take the original or to take what is made available as the alternative? What is the original? The original is the word of God and the plan of God over your health. The pill will take it away, and God will take it away. talking about the sickness. God takes it away without the negative side effects. Exodus 23:26. I will fulfill the number of your days. I don't know who has told you that you only have 5 days to live. You only have 1 week to live. Is that what the word of God says? It says the number of your days you will fulfill. Have you told yourself that? Have you been able to tell yourself, I refuse to accept the report other than what the word of God says? The word of God says the number of your days you will fulfill. So if God has given you, 80 days to live on earth, 90 years rather, and you are still in your 40s, and you are afraid, oh, I don't know what will happen to me, because it's like everybody in my family does not see this years. I speak over your body by the power in the name of Jesus, and the healing power of God touches your body and uproots every pain, every sickness, and takes them away from your body. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive your healing, be made whole, be delivered, be set free right now. In the name of Jesus, be set free right now, be healed right now. In the name of Jesus, let the healing power of God rest in your body. Let it rest on your body and uproot everything that God himself has not planted. Every affliction, let it be lifted right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know, maybe you've not given your life to Jesus, but you're watching this broadcast. This is the time that Jesus wants to come into your life. Remember, he is the one that will uproot that sickness. My duty is to pray for you, but who takes it away? In Jesus. So let's pray so that you invite him into your life and make him your Lord and your Savior. Just pray after me, say, dear Lord, thank you for your word. I accept you into my life as my Lord and Savior. Forgive me my sins. Erase my name from the book of death. Write it in the Lamb's book of life. Take my life and make a miracle out of it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Thank you for making this decision. And welcome into the family of God. Thank you for being a part of 10 Days of Healing by George and Terry Pearson. Day 3. I wish to see you same time next week. Remember to subscribe. Remember to share this video and also to like this video. See you next time when we put up our next broadcast. Bye for now.